Assalamu alaikum, my name is Fatma Al-Ashmawi. I am from Egypt. Today I'm going to show you how to cook mulkhia. Mulkhia is a very famous dish in Egypt. Everybody eat mulkhia. If you visit Egypt and you didn't eat mulkhia, you didn't go there yet. We need to boil the chicken to cook it, so we make the chicken soup. The first thing, I cut the onion and clean it.
Then we get a pot, and as you see, we put about 3/4 of it or 1/3 of it water, and then we put the onion in the water. I have some cardamom here, so it's about, I say, 4 or 5 of these small seeds of cardamom, and then I put that in the water. Take all this to the stove.
Once it is boiled, I put the chicken in. And keep in mind, if your chicken is frozen, it takes about an hour. If it is a fresh chicken, it takes about 3/4 of an hour.
Boiling here with the onion and the cardamom I added. Now I put the chicken inside like this and leave it to boil.
You could buy it like this from the Mediterranean stores, but please be sure you get minced mulkhia.
Sometimes they sell it as leaves, like you see in the picture.
In Egypt, people didn't buy frozen mulkhia. They buy fresh mulkhia. Fresh mulkhia is like about a plant with leaves in it. They brought this, the plant, and they wash it very well, and they let it to dry, because you don't want any water in the leaves. And then they take the leaves, they pick up the leaves, and they start using a lace, looks like this. And once you have all the leaves on the board, then you start doing it, cut it, mince it like this way.
By the way, this is a good exercise for your muscles, because you keep doing that, you're really making a good exercise.
But nowadays, who has time for this? So we buy the frozen one. Now the chicken broth is ready. I like to drain it before I cook the mulkhia. Basically, I take about 2.5 cups of the chicken soup. Sometimes people like it thick, so you can use 2 cups. But I like 2.5 cups. So we pull the inside bag. I need to open this one. So open it like that.
Slide the whole inside the mix. I want to clean exactly what's left there, so it is really get all of it in the pot. Here I have the chicken soup, and I put the mulkhia in it.
I put it in the stove,
low heat. I cover it. Don't forget to cover it. Now I'm gonna check in the mulkhia. As you see, they all sown now, and it is a green, looks like a green soup like this. Now this is ready. I just put that to the side,
and I start to make the most important, which gives a real good taste to the mulkhia, which is going to get the girl. I put 2 cloves of garlic inside it,
and then I have 1 tablespoon of ground coriander.
A tablespoon, put it with the 2 cloves of garlic.
Mince the whole stick. The coriander gives the real good smell to the mulkhia. And the garlic gives it the flavor. Just clean, take what is in here. It mix what I do. I add some oil to it. Olive oil is the best thing for you. It's good for your heart. And then I fry the whole thing. I think that's it. It seems like now it is done. You see, it is start to be very much more smoother and away from each other. And that's when you stop. I did fry the garlic with the coriander, ground coriander, and then I add this to the whole thing. You're gonna hear some kind of a noise that this is coming down. take some of the molokhiya itself and put it here. Just put it like this. Take another spoon and do like this to be sure you get everything in the pan. And then you mix the whole thing, ready to be eaten. So this is your molokhiya.
Be sure you don't cover it, because when you cover the molokhiya, the whole thing goes down. So leave it uncovered. Also, when you have it in the stove and you put it to be thawed, at the beginning when it is a very low heat, you can cover it. But before it boils, you have to take the cover out, because otherwise everything will come down and the soup in the top. Usually, people in Egypt doesn't eat green salad with molokhiya. It doesn't go, because molokhiya is a green thing. So they need something different to eat with the molokhiya. What they do, they eat fried bell pepper. And I'll show you how they do it. It's really a good idea what they do. I get the bell pepper. I like the one to be straight like this. Then I cut it, as you see here. Clean it, then put it into pieces like this. So easy, it's easy. And then you do it this way. By the way, don't throw this, you could use this. So I cut it with it.
Try to take all the seeds from it. If I have something, I can take it out. Here it is, I have this ready to go.
And then, in order for us, after we fry the bell pepper, we need to make the mix for it. What are we gonna do after that? We bring the gourd. Gourd.
You get one clove of oil of garlic, and you get about half a spoon, teaspoon of salt, like this. Put this in it, and you start smashing the whole thing. Like this, then you put the what you smash here, the garlic and the salt, 2 tablespoons of apple vinegar. By the way, apple vinegar reduces your cholesterol.
I think we need to put the
bring a frying pan. I put some oil in it, just enough oil, just when you put the pepper will be okay. Take this
pepper
splash, so be careful. And I leave that to be cooked.
Oh, okay. Cook from the other side.
So I have the bell pepper, the one I cut, and now I fry it. It looks like this. I take that out from the frying pan and put it here in a paper towel so absorb the extra oil in it. And this will be the side dish for the molokhiya. And most of the people in Egypt, they prefer this than the green salad. So it takes the place of the green salad. You serve on the table.
Now I have the bell pepper fried. I like to take the thin layer of it before I put my mix in it.
In Egypt, usually the bell pepper doesn't have that, but here I do it this way. I prefer this way. Then it is here, it looks clean now. Take all this,
and I just put it in a bowl here, like this. Do the same thing here. Now I have my fried bell pepper. Remember when I did this mix, which is basically garlic and vinegar? I pour this on the top of it. Red sauce. Not everybody eat molokhiya with red sauce. Some people prefer to eat it with, some people is not. In my family, we were divided. Some like this and some didn't like this. And my mom said, my God, I know what to do. Another two small cloves of garlic. We put them in the dirt. And this time we smash them and we don't add anything to it. So we smash them like this. You know, when I get married, and anybody who get married in Egypt, the most important thing they have, you should have a dinner.
Oh, maybe useful. It's useful for your kitchen. You use it for so many purposes. I take this. I take a different pot. I put this, the one I smashed, inside here. I add some oil.
We have the small pot here. We put the garlic I smashed. 1 tablespoon of oil. Put it on the garlic, then you will fry the garlic in the oil I added, about 1 tablespoon of garlic. People love garlic, they eat garlic all the time. And by the way, garlic is good for your heart, and it's good also to dissolve your cholesterol. Now I add the tomato paste. I add some. I do low heat. Boil, and then I add some salt to it, a little bit of salt, and do it again. Leave it to boil just like for 2 minutes, and it is done. Usually, molokhia is a summer dish. Because it is has a lot of water in it, soup, it's like a form of soup.
So we put the rice, we put the fried bell pepper, and then we get a small bowl like this, and we put the molokhia, we stir it. And people prefer molokhia in Ramadan because it's like in the form of a soup, and they start with the molokhia. And this will be a typical plate for a family. Sometimes they put bread in it, so it will put the bread like this. And this will be a great dish for Ramadan when everybody get together and eat molokhia. So.